have you asked if I could do a simple towel folding video, and I aim to please, so here it is. I am filming in the day, so there will be some outside noise, but I just urge you to block them out. So I have also made a spray or a spritz for my towels, and I have gone for a more autumnal winter scent. I'm very much into my orange and cinnamon smells at the moment. I guess I'm trying to get into the Christmas spirit a little early this year due to it not being the best of years for anyone. So within this blend, I have used 1/3 of witch hazel, and then I have added 12 drops of sweet orange, 8 drops of cinnamon, 6 drops of peppermint, and 6 drops of clove. And it smells like spiced orange. So I'm going to spray my towels with this beautiful autumnal aroma, just to add a little something to my towel. And I have just done a wash of all of my white towels, but I also have some blush pink towels as well, which I did in a separate wash. So I'll start with one of my bigger towels. So I have this rather large towel, and I usually use my larger towels to place on the bottom of the bed if I'm doing more of an oil-based massage or something of that nature, just so that any oil can be caught onto the towel and easily washed. So I'm really not going to do anything special with these towels. I'm just going to fold them how I would, and usually I like to roll them and then stack them neatly on a tray I have, and I put the rest away in a special designated cupboard for them, because I don't want them mixing with other products or items. I want them to stay as clean and sterile as possible. Obviously, for entertainment purposes, I am touching these towels a lot, but I promise you, these will not be used with clients when I am working again. So, what I might do first is just give the towel a little spritz. Just gently wiggle out any creases or lumps from the towel. Like for that to be displayed at the end. So I'm just going to halve the towel again. And this is about the width in which I would like the towel. And then what I will do is roll it up into a neat little cylinder shape. And as you can see, I am left with the little bit of design on the side. Is that one? I'll just pop it down to the side. So let's do a nice blush pink towel. So here we have my pink towels, and again, it's just a little simple design on the side, which I would like to be displayed if possible. So I'll just lay this one out. And these ones I usually use to place over the pillow, if I'm using a pillow. they're just the right size for that. So I'm just going to give it a little spray. Sounds like the ocean. I know a lot of you agree with that, and that is probably why you wanted this video. It's very relaxing. Again, I'll just halve the towel. And make sure that I have that little bit of detail still running down the towel. So with these ones, because they are quite small, I fold them one more time. So I'll just do that now. And these are quite small once they're folded, but they look quite nice on the top of the bundle which I make. So we'll just fold this one up now. Just keeping it quite tall, because once you let go of it, it will expand. Nice and soft and squishy. So there we have my pink blush one. So I do like to fold my towels a little bit different if they are being stored in a cupboard or something like that. So we'll do one of those next. It's nothing rocket science, it's just a different way to fold a towel. I am no Maria. That lady could make anything from a towel. She is amazing. So I have this medium-sized towel. It's still quite large, but not as big as the first one. And I always try and find the label and make sure it is tucked in to the design of the fold. So I'm just going to spread this out, just quickly, just to give it a little spritz. I'll grab my toner spray. This room is smelling very Christmassy right now. I absolutely adore it. my children enjoy this scent as well. And then I'm going to half the tap. So I'll just grab this side and tuck it inwards so that it is hidden. And we'll just straighten it out a little bit. Usually I would use something to fluff the towels out a little bit, but the towels I have been using recently are so fluffy, they're really nice. And I have actually found that not using too much product or softener in the wash makes them stay a lot more fluffy. Kind of sounds like a cat purring. We digress. So, how I'm going to fold this towel is so I'm going to try and see if I can make it look like it doesn't have any edges. So I'll just fold this side in. And the same with the other side. So once it's like that, I just simply fold it over and half it. And that is just a simple fold of no edges seen when it is in your cupboard. Looks nice and neat and tidy and bouncy. So that is usually how I would fold my towels for going into the cupboard. So I'll just do a few more for you. Going to roll these ones because I need a few more for my display. And usually the ones on my display I don't use. However, I have not really been displaying towels this year due to everything going on. Trying to keep my room as workable as possible. When I am, in fact, allowed to work. So I'll just spray this towel. do personally want to say a big thank you to you all as well. I know there is so much going on in the world right now. It's not just me, it's everybody. And I do remind myself of that frequently. But it has been hard. It's hard not to be able to do the job which you love. I miss my clients and my friends. But I do think I'm very fortunate because Steve is in a very good job, so we're doing okay. But it is a hard pill to swallow when you have worked hard your whole life and then you are told that you are not entitled to any help. And I think that's the thing, a lot more people are in the same position as me, which is sad, really. But I am so very grateful to have you all right now, because my channel is helping a little bit with finances, so thank you so much. I very much appreciate all of you, I really do. I'm just looking forward to going back to work. Okay, so let's fold this then. A slightly different pattern on this one. And I think I will do the rest a little bit later. I'm going to go and get a nice cup of tea. Thank you so much for joining me today for this video. You really don't know how much I appreciate you. Thank you for supporting me through my YouTube journey. If you haven't subscribed, please do. It would be lovely to have you. Leave a comment and a like. And I will see you again soon.